In this video, let's make camera follow player. That using free plugin, Cinemachine. How to use dead zone. What is aim target to change angle of view? How to make all collisions of two layers ignore each other's. Limit screen of camera in orthographic mode and perspective mode in 3D game. When the game runs, press buttons to move player. You want camera must follow player. To control the camera, let's install and use plugin Cinemachine. In Unity registry, search for Cinemachine. Install it. After installing, you can have menu Cinemachine now. Create virtual camera. Rename it Cinemachine. It will add a Cinemachine component to our main camera automatically. To make camera follow player, add player object in follow option. You can see camera now follow player. At body option, change it to framing transposer. It will show what is camera focusing in your screen. Press play to see it better. Camera can follow player now. Let's make some adjustment in framing transposer. Damping is the smooth time to move camera to new position. To disable it, set these values to 0. Screen XY to move the camera left, right, or up, down. Camera distance to zoom in or out. You can play around with these options to see best result for your game. Dead zone is area camera will not move if player is inside the zone. It is showed as blue lines. When player moves inside this dead zone area, camera will not move. If player is outside of dead zone, camera will follow player. Let's find out what is aim option. I will create a 3D cube. Name it aim target. Move it to player position. Now select Cinemachine. Add it into look at. And option aim, choose hard look at. Aim will set direction of camera from player to our aim target. If I move aim target, location of camera will be changed too. Camera will take direction from player to aim target. You can use this option aim in third-person game style, or change the angle of view. But in this game, we don't need it, set it do nothing. When player moves to the end of your map, you don't want this red area showed in your game screen. Or when player drop down to a hole, you don't want the camera follow. Select Cinemachine object. Add extension. Create Cinemachine confiner. Select Confine 3D for 3D game. It requires a 3D collider. I will create a 3D cube for this input collider. Name it Limit Camera. Reset its position. Select this resize tool. Adjust its size to cover all the map that you want camera to show only. Make sure checkbox is trigger for player go through this collider. And turn off the mesh of this area. We use its collider only. Next, in Cinemachine object, Add collider we just created in. Press play. Maybe it will not work yet. The reason is, on your main camera, you are using perspective. Let's try to use orthographic this time. It works, but the Z size look like too thin. Select object, limit camera. Change its Z size bigger. Change it to 10. It's good now. Press play to test it. Camera is limited and not showed the red area. The top is limited too. Same as the right side. I will show you how make it works in perspective a little bit later. There is one issue here. After collider of limit camera is added, player can jump multi times again. The reason is, player always standing on a collider, our limit camera. First, add new layer. Name it player. Next, select all objects of player. Add them into player layer. Select this object only. Then select object limit camera. Add it into ignore raycast. Then open any visual scripting script. Add on start. Use ignore layer collisions. And add two layers, need to ignore each other's into. Use name to layer. Input will be a layer name. Output is the layer number. Let's add layer player and ignore raycast into. We will make all collision of two these layers ignore each others. Press play. Now player objects will never collide with limit camera again. No more multi-jump issue. Let's switch our main camera. Back to perspective mode. Actually, Cinemachine Confine is working. But the size of limit camera is not correct. I will try to move the top of limit camera lower. You can see the camera move down, and focus our player now. But the camera zoom in too much, because Z size is not big enough. Fix it 100 or bigger. Camera distance is good now. But the width is not limited yet. Make the width of limit camera smaller. You can see left side of the screen is limited now. This is how we fix Cinemachine Confine 3D in perspective mode. It worked perfect. Let's move to right side and fix it. Slowly move collider size until you get the best result. The right side of screen is limited well now. Do the same to limit top and bottom of screen too. You understand how to use Cinemachine to move camera in 3D game. You can watch my other videos to see how Cinemachine camera work in 2D game or third person game. Next video, we will learn how to move enemy in Unity. Thank you for watching.